What purpose does the gentleman from Kansas rise?
At the desk.
The clerk will report the amendment.
Amendment offered by Mr. Pulls, Camp of Kansas.
I ask unanimous consent the amendment be considered as read.
Without objection, so ordered.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
The gentleman is recognized for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Today I rise on behalf of the Republican Study Committee to offer an amendment to bring the Interior Appropriations Bill in line with the RSC budget. Mr. Chairman, credit rating agencies around the country are threatening to downgrade our debt, and not because we won't pass a debt ceiling increase, but more so because we have not passed a credible plan to pay that debt back. Every child born in America today owes the federal government over $46,000, and that bill rises every day. The times we are in demand that we look at the effectiveness of every federal dollar we spend, and that is why I offer this amendment today. This amendment makes cuts across the bill, but the biggest cuts come from the EPA. In my opinion, no agency in our federal government has done more to negatively impact our economy than the EPA. In my district in western Kansas, EPA foot-dragging and red tape is delaying the construction of a new power plant. The construction of the plant would create 1,900 construction jobs and 261 permanent jobs, yet they cannot even break ground. Region 7 is asking for changes. Environmental groups continue to file lawsuits based on EPA rules, exacting a death by litigation strategy against the rural electric cooperative members seeking to build this plant. And according to a study by the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, 351 proposed solar, wind, wave, biofuel, coal, gas, nuclear, and energy transmission projects have been delayed or canceled due to significant impediments, such as regulatory barriers, including inefficient review processes and the attendant lawsuits and threats of legal action. The study found that these projects would produce 1.9 million new jobs during construction and almost 800,000 jobs on an ongoing basis. These jobs are simply in limbo when our economy sorely needs them. In fact, not a week seems to go by without the EPA issuing a new rule or regulation that increases the cost to businesses and consumers. Boiler MAC, water cooling intakes for power plants, interstate air quality, dust and other particulate matter, ozone, and the list goes on and on. These actions not only drive up cost, but they create higher degrees of uncertainty in our fragile economy. And when the EPA isn't hampering our economy at home, they're sending our tax dollars abroad. Nearly $1.3 million was sent to China in grants over the past 2 years. Yes, that's right. These grants were sent to the China Coal Institute, the China University of Petroleum, the China Urban Construction Design and Research Academy, and the China Association of Rural Energy Industry. I guess the hundreds of billions of dollars of debt we owe them is not enough. The EPA has long given up sound scientific methods to ensure a clean environment for a left-wing agenda that heaps billions in cost on our economy in exchange for nearly immeasurable incremental change and air quality. Mr. Chairman, this amendment also zeroes out funding for the NEA and the NEH. Federal spending on the arts and humanities has long been controversial, not only for the nature of some of the grants, but also for the fact that I believe the federal government should not play such a role in our society, and certainly should not at a time when we are facing an impending debt crisis. If we cannot make relatively easy decisions to eliminate this funding, how can the American people expect us to make the harder decisions necessary to balance our federal? Mr. Chairman, the amendment also ends funding for National Heritage Area grants. This provision was included as a result of the UCUT program, where the American people could vote on a government program to cut, and this is the one they selected. Federal funding for heritage areas was supposed to be seed capital to get them up and running for the states, localities, and the private sector who requested them. Many of the grants have exceeded the original 10-year limitation. Even the president recommended a 50% cut in his budget for them, which was included in the bill. But in this time of much-needed federal spending restraint, it is time to cut them altogether. Mr. Chairman, I encourage my colleagues to pass this amendment and help put us on a track to balance our budget in the next decade. I yield back my time.
The gentleman from Kansas yields back his time. What purpose does the gentleman